I am not saying that to say that trans women aren't women. I am just saying that those pussies that they got, you know what I mean? I'm not saying it's not pussy, but that's like beyond pussy or impossible pussy. You know what I mean? It tastes like pussy, but that's not quite what it is, is it? It's not blood, that's beet juice. But I can't say the word faggot. And she said, because, David, you are not gay. I said, well, Renee, I'm not a nigger either. But you see, what I didn't realize at the time and what Kevin had to learn the hard way is we were breaking an unwritten and unspoken rule of show business. And if I say it, you'll know that I'm telling you the truth. The rule is that no matter what you do in your artistic expression, you are never, ever allowed to upset the alphabet people. You know who I mean. Those people that took 20% of the alphabet for themselves. I'd say the letters, but I don't want to conjure their anger. It's too late now. I'm talking about them L's and them B's and them G's and the T's. People be surprised. I have friends all kinds of letters. Everybody loves me and I love everybody. I got friends who are L's, I got friends who are B's, and I got friends who are G's. But the T's hate my fucking guts. And I don't blame them. It's not their fault, it's mine. I can't stop telling jokes about these niggas. I don't want to write these jokes, but I just can't stop. You know, you hear all those letters together all the time, LBGT, LBGT, and you think it's just one big movement. It's not. All those letters are their own movement. They just travel in the same car together. And my guess is, what is this, high school? This nigga probably got a babysitter or something. Go on and answer your phone, nigga. Just get that shit out of here. I'm in the middle of something important. Wouldn't it be funny if we made fun of him? He's like, ah, and he went outside like, hello? Mama's dead. Oh, no! Mama's dead. Ah! That's a weird time phone call, wasn't it? It's like his phone is gay.
But motherfuckers are just taking it too far. I don't know why or how everybody got this goddamn sensitive. You know who hates me the most? The transgender community. Yo, yeah, these motherfuckers. I mean, I didn't realize how bad it was. These motherfuckers, I was really mad about that last Netflix special. It's tough, man. I don't know what to do about it, because I like them. Always have. Never had a problem with them. You know, just fucking around. As a matter of fact, I think I make fun of everybody, and I mean, as a group of people, they have to admit, it's kind of fucking hilarious, man. I'm sorry, bro. It's like, I've never seen somebody in such a hilarious predicament not have a sense of humor about it. They're born feeling like there's something other than they're born as, and that's kind of funny, you know? I mean, it's funny if it's not happening to you. It's like that white black bitch that's in the news all the time. Rachel Dolezal. She's a white woman, but then she dressed up like a nigga and shot her way up to the very top of blackness. And I always wanted to meet her just so I could understand. I just wanted to, like, have dinner with her so I could just look in her eyes and call her a nigger to her face. The fuck is that bitch talking about? I identify black. That is trans talk, lady. Stop biting. Stop biting. It's a big difference between her and a trans. The difference between her and a trans is I believe transgenders. I don't understand them either, but I know they mean what they say. Them niggas cut they dicks off. That's all the proof I need. I've never seen somebody just throw their dick away. Don't need it. I don't understand, but I believe you and I support your decision, motherfucker. But how far is Rachel willing to go? What is Rachel willing to do so that we blacks can believe that she believes she's actually one of us? Bitch, are you willing to put a lien on your house? Invest in a mixtape that probably won't work out? She didn't even change her name. Didn't even change her name. Her name is Rachel. I can't believe in that name. If you want my support, you're gonna have to change your name to the blackest shit I've ever heard. Bitch, you're gonna have to change your name to Draymond Green. I don't know a blacker name than that. That shit is black on paper. If you type Draymond Green into Airbnb, that shit will log off automatically. You know, people get mad, bro. People get mad about everything I say. I was doing a show. I was in Portland, Oregon. And I was checked in a hotel under the name Charles Edward Cheese. I came back and there was a note, it was like a letter on my desk. It was addressed to Mr. Cheese. So obviously I'm gonna assume that whoever wrote this letter must be an intimate friend of mine. This is not some kind of name that a person would just guess. But then I opened the letter and it turns out I don't know this person at all. It's a fan letter. You know, I'm not even used to the idea that I have fans, but I'm grateful for it. And even though I'm grateful for fans, I don't read those letters. It'd be nice if I did, but realistically, it's like, what am I, Santa Claus, nigga? I don't have time for this. Like, got shit I want to do. I'm trying to chill. Read all these dreams and wishes from strangers. But I read it. I'd already opened it. So I just read the whole letter. And you know what, man? Whoever wrote this letter truly loves me. I mean, they were really fucking nice in the letter. And then they described to me what it was like to come to the show, how excited they were, how much fun they were having. And then they said that when I got to my jokes about transgenders, that they were, quote, devastated. Because it turns out that whoever wrote the letter was transgender. Now, I'm going to be real for a second. You got to understand, I never feel bad about anything I say up here. Like I was saying, my guess is the G's are driving that car. That makes sense to me, because there's white men in the G's, and these people are trying to get around discrimination and oppression, and you know how white dudes are. We know these roads. In fact, we built these roads. The rest of you buckle up, we'll get you to where you want to go. So the G's are just driving the car.
Of course, next to the G's in the passenger seat is the L's. Everybody likes the L's, except for the G's. I don't know what that's about. I just know the G's don't like them that much. And the G's always say like little subliminal digs on them. It's unnecessary shit. It's not mean, but you know what I mean? They just be like, I wouldn't wear that. The only thing that breaks the tension between the L's and the G's are the B's in the back seat. That's right, there you go. Everybody scream out when you hear your letter. If it's one thing that the L's and the G's agree on, is that the B's are fucking gross. They seem greedy to the L's and the G's, you know what I mean? Because they're just sitting in the back seat like, yeah, man, I'll fuck anybody in this car. What's going on, man? And sitting next to the B's, all the way in the back seat by themselves, looking out the window. That's the T's. Everybody in the car respects the T's, but everyone also resents the T's. It's not the T's fault, but everyone in the car just feels like the T's are making the trip take longer. Anything the T's say gets on everybody's nerves. And then the T's don't even say anything bad. They should be in the back talking to themselves. I'm hot. Shut up. Shut the fuck up, okay? Just roll the window down, you bitch. I don't know what you... What? Just said I was hot. Can you pull over at the next exit? I need to use the restroom. There is not a restroom for you for four states, nigga. Will you just shut the fuck up so we can get where we're going? And just when that car can't get any more tense, the Q's are a hitchhiker that they pick up on the road. Some white dude in booty shorts is walking down the freeway. The G's see him. That guy might be one of us. Hey, are you okay? You need some help? And he come over there with them booty shorts leaning on the window. Hey, what's going on, fellas? Lady? Whatever pronoun makes you feel comfortable in the back. Yeah. I don't really know where I'm going. I don't know if I'm gay or I'm straight or whatever. All I know for sure is that I really want to get in this car. And they make him get in and sit in between the B's and the T's. I feel bad for T's, but they're so confusing. And it's not all my fault. I feel like they need to take some responsibility for my jokes. Because I didn't come up with this idea on my own, this idea that a person can be born in the wrong body, but they have to admit that's a fucking hilarious predicament. It's really fucking funny. If it happened to me, you'd laugh, wouldn't you? That wouldn't be funny if it happened to me? I think it would be. What if it did? What if I was Chinese, but born in this nigga body? That's not funny.
And I would never admit this to you if I hadn't locked your phones up. But it was the weirdest thing. Like, when I read this letter, the shit made me feel bad. I didn't feel bad about what I said, you understand? I felt bad that I made somebody else feel bad. To be honest, I don't even know what I said that upset that person. I have so many transgender jokes. But I feel like it was probably this joke I'm about to tell you right now. And it's not even that bad of a joke. It's a true joke. I mean, it's not true, but I had read in the paper that Caitlyn Jenner was contemplating posing nude in an upcoming issue of Sports Illustrated. And I know it's not politically correct to say these things, so I just figured, fuck it, I'll say it for everybody else. Yuck. Oh, sometimes I just want to read some stats. I don't know why you're going to cram some man pussy in the middle of the sports page like this. I just didn't think that was the place for it. But I wasn't saying anything like Caitlyn Jenner's a bad person. I'm not mad at her for doing it. I'm not even mad at Sports Illustrated. If I'm mad at somebody, I'm probably just mad at myself. You understand? Because deep down, I know that I am not strong enough to not look at those pictures. And I don't think I'm ready to see what she's trying to show me. So Caitlyn, goddamn, if you go through with this thing, bitch, you better go hard or go home. I want you to go all the way. Hustler style. Do you know what hustler style means, miss? That means spread the lips. I hope she spreads her lips and there's an itty bitty dick inside. Ah! The show is behind the curtains. I don't know what I said that upset that person. But I'm going to tell you something. When I read that letter, and the moments after I read it, I did something that many black men in America do not have the time or the money to do. I thought about how I felt. I asked myself a very basic question that I don't think I ever directly contemplated. I said, man, Dave, if you're writing all these jokes, do you have a problem with transgender people? And the answer is absolutely not. The fuck do you guys think I am? I don't understand all the choices that people make. But I do understand that life is hard and that those types of choices do not disqualify you from a life with dignity and happiness and safety in it. But if I'm honest, my problem has never been with transgender people. My problem is transgender people. I just feel like these things should not be discussed in front of the blacks. It's fucking insulting, all this talk about how these people feel inside. Since when has America given a fuck how any of us feel inside? And I cannot shake this awful suspicion that the only reason everybody is talking about transgenders is because white men want to do it. That's right. I just said that. If it was just women that felt that way, or black dudes and Mexican dudes being like, hey, y'all, we feel like girls inside, they'd be like, shut up, nigger. No one asked you how you felt. Come on, everybody. We have strawberries to pick. It reeks of white privilege. You never asked yourself why it was easier for Bruce Jenner to change his gender than it was for Cassius Clay to change his fucking name? And if I were to be brutally honest, the only reason I ever been mad at the transgender community is because I was at these niggas for six songs straight. And then the lights came up and I saw them knuckles. I said, oh no! And everybody was laughing at me. Ah, world star. I said, why didn't you say anything? And then I heard that sultry voice.
I didn't say anything, Dave Chappelle, because I was having a wonderful time. And I wasn't sure how you'd feel about it.
I said, you knew how I'd feel.
And she said, I'm going home. I don't want any trouble from you. I said, home, it's only two songs left. I mean, we might as well finish the night. And we ended up having breakfast together. Oh, grow up, that doesn't make me gay. I just titty fucked her. His titties are as real as any titties in LA. It's 2 o'clock in the morning, I was just borrowing a little friction from a stranger. Whoops!
Although Dave Chappelle, the black American, he was a little jealous. I was like, how the fuck are transgender people beating black people in the Discrimination Olympics? If the police shot half as many transgenders as they did niggas last year, it'd be a fucking war in LA. I know black dudes in Brooklyn, hard street motherfuckers, that wear high heels just to feel safe. Transgenders are gangsters. I used to do business with a transgender in Hollywood. Man, everybody would be scared of her in the boardroom. She'd walk in there, newly minted woman, high heels, purse. Wouldn't say anything to us, just walk around the conference table looking mean as shit. Then she walked to the head of the conference table, stare at us all, reaching a person, pull her old dick out and throw it on the table. Let's talk business, gentlemen. It is scary as fuck. If your best friend pitched that to you, you'd be horrified. Yo, nigga, let's go to the hospital and cut our dicks off and make pussies out of them shits. What? Can't we just get matching jackets or tattoos or something? Sure, that's what you want to do. It's only one way to find out, nigga. Woo, tang, bow, bow. Let's go to the club and trick niggas into fucking us, yeah. Third time I met O.J. Simpson. Third time I met O.J. Simpson, I was doing great in life. I just finished the second season of Chappelle's Show. Man, those were good days. I was playing a comedy club in Miami, the Improv. I don't know if you've ever been, but if you have, you'd know. The door for the green room is right on the stage. Can you imagine such a thing? If I walked out of the door of the green room, bam, I'm just right here. It's right from the dressing room. And I did that. I walked out, and the whole crowd was like, hooray! And I looked, ma'am, as close as you are to me, I saw him as soon as I came out. The juice. And I saw recognition in his eyes, and it filled me with pride that he knew who I was. I didn't acknowledge his presence because it was a white audience, and I didn't want to start a panic. But I did my show. Show went great. I said, good night, everyone. They all said, yay! And I didn't say nothing to OJ, but I just gave him a signal, let him know I knew he was there. And I walked into the green room, and OJ was already in there. I was like, how the fuck is this possible? I was scared. Then my friends came in, and we all started talking. We sat down on the couch, and I'm just telling you what I saw with my own eyes. You can believe me or not believe me. But in my experience, OJ Simpson, one of the nicest men I'd ever met. He was nice to me. He was nice to my friends. The conversation was filled with warmth and levity, humor, and wisdom. We talked for 90 minutes, and then suddenly the Jew said, you know what? I've got to be going. But it's good to see you again, and I'm glad things went so well. I said, thanks, Juice. And my friend said, yeah, goodbye, Mr. Juice. They're new to the game. He said, no, thank you for your hospitality. Good night, guys. And we said, good night. And he just walked out of the room. And as soon as the door closed, we all looked at each other like, that nigga did that shit. I feel like murder in the room.